Guys, there have been some trending news happening in the social media right now about the government arresting minors because they came out for to protest because of the hunger. They are hungry and they came out to protest, and the government arrested them and said that these small boys want to destroy the country. How will these small boys, as you now, want to destroy this country? Minors around 17, 19 years want to destroy a full country. But let me like guys, so just watch what this man said, and first of all, judge by yourself, and I'll be with you guys shortly.
These boys that we brought to the court today, all of them are adults. Most of them are married men. None of them is a minor. Some of them are university graduates. The small, small kids you are seeing here, they came with some of their parents to come and greet their loved ones. They are not even the real suspect standing trial in this case. These boys were arrested in Kaduna and Zaria. Imagine the level we find ourselves now. Do you know how much it costs us to be at this level of a democracy in this country? These young boys are trying to destabilize Nigeria using the Russian flags and other countries, calling on the military to remove our president. Is it fair? To even remove the state governors, that they don't want democracy again. If you don't like democracy, are we forcing you? You go back home and sit. Everybody is enjoying their fundamental rights. Nobody is abusing their rights. Everybody is enjoying free movement. And everything's moving fine in the country. These boys, only for no reason, they started protests, violent protests with their flags. Foreign flags, Russian flags. Haba, is that what we want in this country? Don't mind the Defense Council. They will always say something to tarnish the name of Nigerian police. It's not true. In my own case, we filed charge against 43 defendants. And all of them were produced to the court today. All of them are adults. Forget about what they are telling you, that they are small children, this and that. Ask the Defense Council, do they truly know the suspect they're defending?
See, I want to ask, how did we get to this level where you could imagine what that man was saying? That those minors were not arrested, that they came to visit, that they are not minors, that they have graduated from school. These same children we are seeing like this are graduates from school. These children that we are seeing like this are not arrested by the police because they've been there for over 90 days, malnourished. To the extent that some or four collapsed in the court, and those people you saw eating something was bought by their lawyers. That means the Nigerian government planned on starving those children to death. Because if not that this lawyer persisted in this case would have been dumped sometime and those children would be in court. I mean, prison for no reason. Like the man said, that for no reason they protested. That means that the protest that happened was for no reason. And you see that the country is going away. This same country where you see is going away. And so I came out to see that Tinubu, why do they want to remove Tinubu or why do they remove the government? That is because I think they've paid him some amount of money to come and speak such things that he said. Because I think on the normal self, we all are aware of what's happening in our country. We all know how the level we are in our country. And then a man can come out to say and utter such words and lie on such or this same Nigeria we are all seeing. And that's why they say that this country is into two parts, the rich and the poor. Because tell me why Yahaya Bello that have been caught or that have been investigated to in Kogi State that stole 84 billion naira. And till today, he's moving on the street freely. But here are men that came out to protest because of hunger and the police arrested them. But I never like that to watch and hear what they said, and I'll meet you guys shortly.
You see, basically, our own is very simple. Why should children... Why should small children, why should they spend 93 days in police custody when they should be in school? And the government can arrest 10, 12, 13-year-old and keep them in custody for 93 days. But the government has not been able to arrest Yahaya Bello 6 months after. Is it not a parody of some sort that we have two separate countries? One country for the rich, one country for the poor. Our laws are very clear. It's 48 hours. The police are in breach of the fundamental rights of these children. So we are not going to delve into the substance of the issue, which is already before the court, so that we will not make remarks that are sub judice. But what we are saying, very simple, Yaya Bello, 6 months later, has not been arrested. But you arrest our children. You keep them in custody for 93 days. These children, they are already looking like they have kwashoko. They are malnourished. You understand? Then you cannot keep them in custody for this long. This is the reasons why our rating in the human rights index is poor, is bad. You understand? The Tinubu government should discontinue the charge. We make a passionate appeal to the AGF, you know, Baba Latif Fagbemi, that he should discontinue the charge. He should take over the matter and discontinue against these children, so that the children can return back to school. And the Attorney General of the Federation has the inherent powers to take over this matter under Section 174 of the Constitution, that Baba Latif Fagbemi should take over this matter and discontinue the charge against the children. I cried in open court because of this grave injustice that has been done to this kid.
Maybe the recording can just stop for now. Let's just take a pause and see what's going on. Let's just organize ourselves.
Kids. Talk, you die. If you don't talk, you die. So we'll talk and die. While we were in court this morning, and shortly before the plea of the defendants, mainly underage children could be taken. Some of them who were looking quite malnourished, who were looking quite very sick, started snooping in court before the Honorable Justice Eguatu. Justice Eguatu, upon seeing the fainting of these young persons of school age, had to adjourn proceedings abruptly. We had to rush some of these young children to the clinic. Within the facility of the court for them to be resuscitated. Some of them are still receiving treatment as I speak to you in the clinic. This young person has been arrested since the second day of August 2024. Over 3 months, they've been left without clothing, without housing, without proper care. They are looking very malnourished, as you can see the videos that are flying around social media. They were kept at the Kuje Correctional Center and at the IRT, the notorious IRT at SAS Abattoir. IRT now, that is where they are kept. At SAS Abattoir. Now, this is the facility that has held our young children who should be in school that have been kept by this government over allegations of attempting to overthrow the president. The question now comes to, how can a 12, 13, 14-year-old boy who is looking very frail and malnourished attempt to overthrow the president? That is a matter for another day. But we have filed an application contesting and challenging the powers of the courts to try these young persons. And this objection is founded on very solid foundation. The Constitution of Nigeria in Section 18 vests on the government the responsibility of educating young persons. The Universal Basic Education Act and the Children and Young Persons Act vest upon the government the duty to educate its younger ones. Section 2 of the UBEC Act mandates the government to provide education for its young persons. Free, compulsory education for all young persons. Unfortunately, young Nigerians have been arraigned in court today on a 10-count charge of an attempt to overthrow and overhaul the government of Nigeria. They have been granted bail. We will strive hard to meet the bail conditions, if we can. The conditions are quite neck-breaking. It is like giving bail with the right hand and taking with the left hand. We will strive and do our best to perfect these conditions. But if we cannot meet the bail conditions, we will come back to the court and seek for evaluations. Because we have shown that these are young persons who are hungry. The essence of the protest of August 2nd is to end hunger in the land. And we saw them in court today, looking quite malnourished. The problem persists.
Well, what actually happens... It's okay, thank you.
No, this is the week. Go ahead.
What actually happens today is that the 76 defendants were brought for arraignment, who were alleged to have participated in this violent uprising against the government in Kano State. What actually baffles me today is that a matter of a sovereign national interest, a situation where a youth of this particular country would organize themselves into a violent protest, calling on an outsider to come and take over power from the government of Nigeria, otherwise than by constitutional means, this situation will never be tolerated.
So, you have the details of the ruling.
What actually happened? The details of the ruling is that the matter has been adjourned to January 24 for the substantive hearing of the matter so far. And the court has graciously granted a bail on a very, very stringent conditions, which they are to be remanded in Kuje Correctional Centers, while others are to be remanded in the Boston Trading, pending the hearing of the substantive charge. But the point I want to make, I just want to make a point, please. These people have been in lawful custody of the police for a considerable length of time, and none of them exhibited any sickness. But unfortunately, they were instigated by lawyers. Yes,
we got back. We are like very far from getting a better country, like very far. In the country where someone can come out and make that speech, like that person that posted, where someone said that. They remind us that they're working against the government and so on. So we are so far from getting the better content. And I don't think we can get that, achieve that. Because corruption, like I said, has eaten so deeply into the system. To the extent a man can come out and all that sort of statements, such words. That is Nigeria not doing well, that we are doing well, but why would they want to come and spoil our legacy? In a country that we are, you know, that is not going anywhere, that is not working. Or someone can come up boldly to make such statements. No, no, it doesn't make sense. So get a better country, we are still far, we are far back. Or if we don't address the roots, we can never get a better country. And since we want to get the roots, the best way to do it is following the Ghana's way, which is said, give us Biafra, Yoruba Nation, go their own, Hausa, go their own. That's the only way and way forward. Because how can that video is shocking me that a man in the camera, you are aware that this camera is on and you're making sure statements. Just everything about this video you watched in the comment section. I will be with you guys in my next video. If you are new here, you can subscribe, like my videos and share. I will see you guys also in my next.